Okay, can we hear me now? Ah, that's better. Now I can mute myself again. Bring the microphone a bit closer to me. No, I don't want that to happen. Okay, I can't do it. Well, that'll be a job for tomorrow. I've got to move my microphone. It's got a tendency of dropping when it's too far away. So Blue need to make their boom arm a little bit better. We'll see how that goes. What I might do, I'll go into the game and we'll turn sound effects down, turn everything down a bit, so if I talk the game won't be so loud. I don't know if anyone heard before, since I don't know if my microphone was actually being recorded or not. I've got the Warthog joystick and throttle and the pedals set up in a homemade cockpit. I'm in the Anaconda, obviously. I'm out near Beagle Point. I'm just making my way home now. But you know, home, back to the bubble, I mean. So when I came out to Beagle Point, I went from went from the bubble through a couple of nebulas to Sagittarius A, from Sagittarius A to Colonia, from Colonia to Beagle Point. Now I'm making my way back home. So when I get back home eventually, I'll be able to buy myself one of these awesome fleet carriers. I don't think I'm going to outfit it with absolutely everything. I'm thinking for myself, I only want a couple of the services on it. Like refueling, repairs, maybe cartographics. Um, and maybe the market. I'm not sure yet. I still haven't made my mind up fully on it yet. And why I say those things is so when I go out exploring, I can sort of take it with me, and if like, oops, there, as you can see, taking on damage, I can repair myself. Well, repair my ship. Obviously, I can't repair myself because I'm not a doctor. I'm not up there in fuel jumps. I'm not up there with distance and jumps. I think the best that my ship can do is around 37 light years. Where is it? Yeah, there you go. Oops. So current's 37.71, unloading 39.36. It's not too bad. A little bit long in the tooth to be coming out to Beagle Point though, in my opinion. So this is another reason why I'm going back home, so I can outfit my ship so it can go longer distances. But I still have enjoyed coming out here. It's been freaking fantastic. I've found everything bar the I'd say the K or the M class star in the giant star, in the giant star version. I've got to find one of them and put my name on it, and I've got to find a Wolf Riot star and put my name on it. Otherwise, I think I've found everything else in the galaxy. So I've got my name out there, so I'm happy with that. Yes, my shields are off. Don't need them, so I'm not under attack out here yet. Got the throttle back. And this is where all that damage is coming from, doing silly mistakes like that. But I was actually looking on the web page for something and I've got the throttle back. I'm not worried, ship is still in good condition, sort of. Where am I? Yeah, we're still okay. What's the power plant? Power plant's at 87%, so that's still alright. I'll be right. I hope. I don't want to blow up and die. Not out here. Okay.
shift drive charging.
I'm looking at it. Damn it. Try that again.
Frame shift drive charging. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Weird. Pointed straight at it and it still didn't want to let me jump. That actually isn't the first time I've encountered that. The paint scheme I've got on my ship is the copper one. You can only do that at the main menu. I was going to go into the library and show this, but anyway, it doesn't matter. Yeah, it's the copper one that I'm using. I was using the, I think it was the palladium one or something. One of those blue ones. I tried this one out, it just looked a little bit better when you're up against the star and, yeah. That was my thought anyway.
Fuel scooping. System scan complete. Fuel scooping complete.
Never gets tiring in VR going around in sunlight like that. It's just awesome. I don't check every system doing that either. But I've just figured that every now and then, depending, at the start of my gaming session, I'll try and get my name in on a few planets at the start, and then I'll just jump like crazy. And then somewhere along the line, say an hour, 2 hours into that gaming session, I'll stop and take my time a little bit and put my name on a few systems and that, and then I'll jump like crazy for another couple of hours or until the end of that gaming session, and then do a few more. That's the way I've been doing it while I've been coming out to Beagle Point. And that's the way I'm going to do it on the way back to the bubble, so. I might upload this video to YouTube as well, so. Stupid hippie. Nice night.
Frameshift drive charging.
Marlon Blake. Hello, Marlon. I was going to stop this at 7 o'clock, but I'll go till 7:30, I think. I know it says 9 o'clock up there, but for me it's like 7:30 at night. So I'll give it another 20 minutes before I call it the night, because I've got to have tea and all of that. Maybe watch some Star Trek Voyager or Stargate. Yes, I am a space nerd, or just a nerd. Take your pick. But yeah, it's tomorrow at some point. I would like to, if my internet is as good as tonight, is be on here for most of the day tomorrow. I know, it's pretty boring just jumping and all that, but hey. Come and talk to me. Say hi. Don't be shy, it's not like I can reach through the monitor and pull you into Elite Dangerous and abduct you like an alien, like a big black-eyed alien. I'm not a grey, I'm not a kidnapper, I'm not a Thar God either. But I might be a Thar God sympathiser. Barefoot Bandit.
Four, three, two, one.
Engage. Make it so. Hip to B square, yeah.
Fuel scooping complete.
No, I'm not gonna give up my day job. I'm not gonna try and sing, because I can't sing for shit. At least I'm honest. That'll take me about an hour to do. 65 jumps.
Frameshift
So he's looking forward to Odyssey. I am.
System scan complete.
Hello out there, person, if someone's watching. That stupid hippie again. Give it about another 14 minutes before I end this stream.
Frameshift drive charging.
Out near Beagle Point, if you're wondering. Been to Beagle Point, I'm now making my way back home. So from Clonia, I actually came from, obviously Clonia is out here somewhere, one of those blue bookmarks here, and I sort of can't quite remember actually. I think I came to about here somewhere. And sort of out here. But I got to, where was it? Yeah, that's right, I got to about here, the corner of this edge here. Anyway, when I got here, I was trying to plot a course straight to Beagle Point, and it kept failing. I'm thinking, you know, because it's the first time I've been out here, I'm thinking the game's breaking, you know. I should be able to plot a course straight across there, but I didn't realise, because I was out here somewhere when I was trying to plot it, I didn't realise there's like a big vast of empty space in amongst it all somewhere. So I had to, yeah, I eventually figured it out, but I had to come down here a little bit, which is why this bookmark's here, and then sort of cut across all those bookmarks is because I, as I got closer to this one, I started adjusting my course, and that was the first one. Then as I started cutting across, I adjusted again, that was the second one, and so forth until I was up there, come across. Instead of coming all the way down here and going there, it saved me, you know, probably a few hundred jumps or something.
Frameshift drive charging.
You wouldn't think there would be a big empty pocket there, like you should be able to jump, still be able to jump across the abyss. Like there's still stars in that there, but yeah, they're just too far apart for my ship to handle. I don't know if someone else can do it, like in their ships or whatever, but. When I get back to the bubble, I don't think I'll be repairing the paint job on this. This will be one ship that will be staying where paint job is all worn out and that. Just to show that it's done some travelling. Geez, I'm not having much lucky finding an unnamed system. So the best I could do, jumping system to system without looking at system maps and all that, was 43 seconds. That's just doing what I'm about to do now. Scan, fuel scoop, jump. And pushing the ship to its limits. I'm not saying every system was 43 seconds, but yeah, I timed myself on a few and that was about what I could get. If you time it right, you're still fuel scooping when you activate the frame shift drive. Don't know if I can get it any better than that if I modify the ship, do some engineering or whatever, might be able to. But I don't think it'll be much better than that.
Thank you.
time this next jump. This one's going to be a little bit long. Because I basically had to do a U-turn there. Try this system. 53. Fuel scooping.
Frameshift drive charging.
Forty-two seconds. Oh wow, my best yet. Like I said, it's not like that all the time. But on that note, this is my last jump, and then tomorrow I will be on, hopefully. So,
ready to engage.
I was looking at the wrong one.
Too
busy gas bagging. So yeah, hopefully all goes well tomorrow and I'll be streaming again. I know, it's boring, jumping, but hey, it's a little dangerous. Fuel scoop and park the ship.
Fuel scooping complete.
Look at that view. Beautiful. Alright guys, thanks for watching, well, talking to myself, bye.